All right, now that we are in Photoshop and we have our floor plan ready to work on, we're going to do the very first step, which is to poche the walls. It's going to be really easy. You'll be very pleased with how quickly this goes. So the first thing we're going to do is use our magic wand tool. Your magic wand tool will be the fourth one down. Right now, my magic wand tool is hiding under another one. You see these little arrows here? Those arrows indicate that there are more tools hiding underneath. So you just right click and you'll see the other options. So I want the one that is magic wand tool and not quick selection tool. So that's what I'm going to use. What I'm going to do is click in the center of all my walls so that I can poche them. So in Photoshop, we do a lot of choosing or selecting something and then doing something to it. So that'll hopefully make more sense. So so you'll see if you take your magic wand and you just kind of click on stuff, it'll select different things. So what I want to do is select the walls. So I'm going to select the wall and then I hold down shift, because in Photoshop, shift means add to, control means subtract. So I'm going to hold down shift key. And at the same time, you can see there's a little plus sign now. I'm gonna click on all the walls that I want to poche. And there we go. So what I'm going to do now is start a new layer. Super important. You have to put everything on different layers because of the magic of Photoshop is best harnessed this way. So what I'm gonna do is down over here, the little symbol that looks like a brand new piece of paper being torn off a pad, we click on that, and then it says layer. And I'm just gonna click, I'm gonna double click quickly right on the word layer. And it's gonna let me rename it, and I'm gonna rename it walls. All right, and now I'm gonna make sure that I am on this layer. You'll see that you can click on different layers. It doesn't change what's happening here in terms of what's selected. So I can click on different layers. I want to make sure that my walls layer is active. I would say 90% of the problems that people have in Photoshop, it's because they're on the wrong layer. So that's something to always check. Make sure you're on the layer that you want to be on. In our case, we want to be on walls. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to go to our color picker. So right over here, I'm just going to click on here. This is right here, our color picker. So it's also shown right here. Basically in Photoshop, you have what's called a foreground color and a background color. Really easy to tell which is which because foreground's in front. Also something I haven't mentioned yet, but it's just may have already been obvious that when you just kind of hover your mouse over something, it'll tell you what it is. So if you're like, oh, I wonder what this paintbrush does, let go of it and it'll tell you not only what it is, but it does a really quick little demo to show you how you can use it, which is a newer feature of Photoshop. So anyway, let's make sure that black is our foreground color, and it already is, but if for some reason, you know, if the person using the computer before you, maybe, you know, maybe they had magenta as their foreground color. Click on that and make magenta my foreground color, which is, you know, not what we want to poche our walls with, because walls, of course, are not supposed to be the focal point. So you just, in this big, you know, color picker here, you can see that you can click down here and you can always choose black and white. And then you can also slide this around and get any color you want. And it can be an intense color, it can be a pastel color, you know, you have all these options. So we want black, so I'm going to pick black. And now I'm gonna go over to the paint bucket tool. So here it is. So let me show you where it could also be hiding underneath the gradient tool or this 3D material drop tool. So make sure that you pick the paint bucket tool. And now we're gonna go over and make sure you're on walls, and we're gonna go ahead and click. And now we have our walls pocheted just like that. And then to make these, we call them the marching ants, the dashed line that's kind of moving. To make it go away, you can do Control D on your keyboard will make those go away. And look at those beautiful Poche walls. When you get to this point, you can stop and go on to the next video.